Welcome back. So we are headed to Astoria, Oregon now. It's gonna be a long day. Sure, she's telling me to go right here, and this is a one-way street. Oh, towards. I'm going to Taylor Street. Never mind. Google Maps, you are correct.
Turn right onto Southwest 14th Avenue.
Yes, that's here. So that was the 405 we just crossed.
In 1,000 feet, keep left.
There's a coffee place called the Super Joy Coffee Lab. That looks fun. So it's 1 o'clock right now. So Powell's bookstore is down here also. I love that bookstore. That's where we always used to go, is Powell's bookstore and Voodoo Donuts. The Voodoo Donuts line is really long normally. Like, you'll wait outside in the morning 30 to 40 minutes. But their donuts are awesome. All
right. In 1,000 feet, merge onto I-405 North.
Well, that wasn't too bad. Yeah, so in downtown Seattle, most of the damage was done in a core central area.
Merge onto I-405 North, then use the left two lanes to take exit 3.
As far as I can tell, Portland downtown, it's everywhere. It wasn't like concentrated in any one spot. Next time I come, yeah, we'll take the 405 bridge. A lot easier than the way I came in this time.
Continue for 93 miles.
I just can't imagine what the property owners are thinking. You know, when your businesses and when your buildings, your land is getting destroyed and no one's doing anything. Like, I don't know what I would do if I owned the property. Like, I mean, just imagine if someone came to your house and started destroying things and graffitiing. Like, how would you feel? Like, wouldn't it be good? Vandalism. just, I hope that it solved all their problems and things are getting better in Portland, Oregon, for the people that live here. I hope they're happy, or I hope they find their happy places. Because that's all anyone really wants. Wanted to go there with a friend on a weekend, and I'm like, yeah, I don't know how safe that would be, like, especially if you're walking around at night. I don't even know how safe it'd be during the day in some of those places. If she really wants to go, I will go with her or them. I mean, some of those people I saw walking around, I swear, like, they're on drugs, or they look kind of scary, you know, like, they're not all there. I really do hope they fix all the problems and get Portland back to normal. Good to be on the highway again. Oh, there's a railroad track. I couldn't slow down. Ah, that's the BNSF Hub Center on my right. Wow, what is this guy backing up to? Oh, this video should turn out awesome. Driving away from the sun. Wow, that's a poorly planned warehouse. I was watching the Big Rig channels earlier today. I found a couple more good ones. I really like watching them. So I'm not sure I've ever taken this road to Astoria. I want to say it's the one the bikers take when they bike across the country, but I'm not sure. Yeah. They'll take care of you. There's a really neat, bright yellow house back there. Yellowish orange tint. I'm not really sure what neighborhood they consider this. As you can see, Vancouver on the other side of the river. And a bunch of other drawbridges crossing the river. Ah, that's the St. John's Bridge. I think I saw. Oh no, the St. John's Bridge is in front of me. Wow, it's a big bridge. I didn't realize they had other bridge crossings that big here. That thing's massive. We'll have to drive around Portland more and do all those cool bridges. Cars there? Are they loading them there? Probably unloading, I would guess. From Japan, maybe, or Korea? It is massive. It would be fun to come down and watch the ships here, like bring my Canon camcorder and zoom in while they're, you know, on them loading and unloading stuff. That would be fun. All Seattle has is cargo containers. Wow, that is neat. Oh, I need to slow down. Speed limit's 35. This whole area of Southwest Washington, Northeast Oregon is really fun to, it's very scenic with the river. Parking lot, and there's a trail along the ravine, it looks like, where you go up. I think this is Linton. I saw a sign that said Linton Community Center. A lighthouse bar and restaurant. I'm on vacation. I hope you're enjoying this. It sure is fun. I'm getting 40 some miles a gallon. Helens is definitely a major port. I will say that. Keep bringing food until COVID's over. Wow, that's quite the bridge they have going out to that island. I might use all of my memory card today. Need to get another memory card for once the sun comes out more and I'm on the road longer. I will fill it up. they do repairs and customizations. Really nice building. We have 76 miles yet. Here's the Rosebud Cafe. Fiat is the smart car's cousin, that's all I have to say. They're kind of similar. And I think that thing has a rear engine. Just like, this. Yeah, I can see it. I think I see the muffler below it. Alright, St. Helens is in 7 miles. We're gonna keep this video going. camera back farther from the windshield than I did last time it rains, maybe it wouldn't look bad having the raindrops on, because it won't focus on them, I don't think. But I don't know if I'm going to find out on this trip. It's a long way to come back. Thanks for watching.